Hi, this is Mato. In this video, I will show you a game between Zygbel Tarash and Alexander Alekhine. This game was played in Baden-Baden in 1925. And where is Baden-Baden? Baden-Baden is a town in Germany. Zygbel Tarash had white pieces and he started with e4. Alexander Alekhine played e5, knight to f3. Knight to c6, bishop to c4, Italian game, bishop to c5, c3, preparing d4. Knight to f6 is the most played move. Alekhine played bishop to b6, d4, queen to e7, Zygbel Tarash castled kingside, knight to f6, rook to e1, if d5, knight to b8, bishop to d3, d6. So we have rook to e1, d6, a4, a6, making the room for the bishop, h3, preventing bishop to g4. Alekhine castled kingside, bishop to g5, h6, white to move. Tarash played bishop to e3. Perhaps Tarash was worried if he plays bishop to h4, that g5 may be coming, and then king to h7, rook to g8, something like that. So we have bishop to e3, black to move. This is very interesting moment. Alekhine played a move which some sources said that he thought very highly of this move. Alekhine said that this move is the best move in the whole game. Interesting. Bishop to d3, rook to e8, knight from b to d2, bishop to a7, queen to c2, e takes on d4, white to move. Now, white would love to capture with the pawn. But then knight to b4, let's have a look. If c takes on d4, then d5 first. And after e5, knight to b4 attacking the queen. If black queen was on e7, then pawn takes knight and then pawn takes queen. But this is not the case. Queen to c3 or something like that must be played. Then knight takes bishop, queen takes knight, knight to d7, and black is okay. So in the game, Tarash recaptured with the knight, preventing knight to b4. Knight to e5, bishop to f1, d5, rook from a to d1, c5, from 4 to b3, queen to c7, bishop to f4, pinning the knight. Black to move, what would you do? The best way to unpin is knight to f3, check. Knight takes knight, queen takes e takes on d5, bishop to f5, attacking the queen. Bishop to d3, if queen to d2, with the idea to exchange queens, queen takes pawn on a4. So we have bishop to d3, with the idea, bishop takes bishop. Let's have a look what was the idea. If bishop takes bishop, queen takes bishop, and now if c4, then queen to d2, after queen takes queen, knight takes queen, knight takes on d5, knight takes on c4, and white is better. Perhaps if bishop takes on d3, queen takes, black as queen takes on a4. But then queen is no longer dangerous around white king. Okay, back to our game. Alekhine didn't capture the bishop. He played another move. A better one. What is it? Please pause the video and find the best move for black. What did you find? Did you find this brilliant move? Bishop takes on h3. Pawn takes bishop. Queen takes knight. Rook takes rook. Perhaps bishop to f1 was better. Rook takes rook, rook takes rook, bishop to f1, defending the pawn on h3, but now rook to e5, threatening rook to g5. c4, rook to g5 check, king to h2, black to move. What would you do now? Please pause the video again and find the best move for black. What did you find? If bishop to b8 check, then d6. Alekhine played knight to g4 check. Pawn takes knight. Black played a move and white resigned. The move is rook takes on g4. White resigned in view of this continuation. Bishop to h3, rook to h4, and white has no sensible defense. One less sensible goes like this. Queen to f5. Queen takes queen. Rook to d3. Queen takes rook. King to g1. Queen takes on h3. f3. Queen takes pawn on f3. d6, trying to get a new queen. And then rook to h1. Checkmate. What a game. What do you think of this game? Did you find that brilliant move in this position? Bishop takes pawn. If you did, congratulations. And that is all. I hope that you enjoyed watching this video. I wish you good luck with your chess, and bye for now.